between blues and theater and that sort of my life. So I would consider myself more of an actor. I think a good singer. You know, I like movies in some ways as much as I like the theater in some ways.
What happened?
Well, like I said, I was just out on the town celebrating a car I bought yesterday. I went to this bar.
What's the name of the bar?
Oh, I didn't get the name.
Where was it?
9th Avenue between 21st and 22nd Street.
Go ahead.
Well, I met this girl, see, and we had a couple of drinks, and she got to liking me, and she asked me if I'd take her for a ride in my car. So we left that place, we drove around for a bit, and went up the West Side Highway to a place called the Cloisters, and we stayed up there a while.
Wanna dance?
My name is You dancing or taking a tour?
I'm dancing. What do you think? Come on. You have a nice body, you know that?
You think so?
Yeah.
Look at my name.
Listen. Do you put out?
You mean at least?
What do you mean? Do you put out or don't you?
No.
I don't know what I'm doing talking to you. Somebody like you ought to be asking me.
About this McCluskey. Huh? What do we do with this copy?
They want to have a meeting with me, right? It will be me, McCluskey, and Saluzzo. Let's set the meeting. Get our informers to find out where it's going to be held. Now, we insist it's a public place, a bar, a restaurant, some place where there's people so I feel safe. They're going to search me when I first meet them, right? So I can't have a weapon on me then. But if Clemenza can figure a way to have a weapon planted there for me, then I'll kill them both.
Hey, what are you gonna do? Nice college boy, huh? Didn't want to get mixed up in the family business? Now you want to gun down a police captain? Why, because he slapped you in the face a little bit? Huh? What do you think, this is the army where you shoot him a mile away? You gotta get up close like this, and bada-bing, you blow their brains all over your nice Ivy League suit. Come here. Mwah! You're taking this very personal. Tom, this is business, and this man is taking it very, very personal.
Where does it say that you can't kill a cop?
Come on, Mikey.
Tom, wait a minute. I'm talking about a cop that's mixed up in drugs. I'm talking about a dishonest cop. A crooked cop who got mixed up in the rackets and got what was coming to him. That's a terrific story. And we have newspaper people on the payroll, don't we, Tom? They might like a story like that.
They might. They just might.
It's not personal, Sonny. It's strictly business.
Eye to eye with me, the guy tells me what freight train to catch. You know? I'll be damned.
Well, that's because you look ridiculous. See, yeah, he saw the humor in
you. Oh, I see.
Humor.
Humor.
You know something, Max? You used to look scary and ridiculous. Now you just look ridiculous.
Well, really. It's because I'm becoming a scarecrow, right?
That's right. You're a scarecrow.
I'm a scarecrow, huh?
You're also an asshole.
Hey, no.
You're also a scarecrow, too.
Okay. But I'm like you, huh?
I'm a scarecrow. That's right. You're right.
Listen, have you taken a good look at your mug lately? Have you eyeballed it? I mean, if that's what being a scarecrow is, I don't want any part of that, I'll tell you.
Scarecrows are beautiful. Scarecrows are beautiful.
Hey, miss. Can we have some coffee down here for Mr. Scarecrow?
Scarecrows are beautiful.
Hey, I'm feeling good. I mean, I really feel good.
They would take all that energy, see, put it into straight police work, we'd have the city cleaned up in a week. They'd clean up, there'd be no crime. See, if I could work alone, that's the thing, see. If I could just get work alone. But they don't like that, see. They don't want that. They want to suck in.
You go over the same thing, Paco.
So fucking corrupt, everybody, everyone, nobody giving a shit. There's got to be a way to wipe it out. God damn it, there's got to be a way.
Let's get out of here for a while, huh, honey? Let's go to a movie.
Oh, you quit handling me? What are you doing? Go to a movie. How am I going to go to a movie? You know they'd kill me if they knew. Do you know that? You think that hasn't happened?
Either you're exploding or you lie around like a catatonic. I can't stand it, Paco.
Don't give a shit, right?
All I care about is you. That's all that matters to me. That's why it hurts so much I can't stand to see you like this. Scared. Miserable, dreading to go to work, it's tearing me apart. And then I get sick of hearing about it and I start hating myself.
Right. You didn't like the whole idea of my being a cop, so don't give me that shit. You never did.
I love you, Paco. I want to marry you. I want to have children with you.
God damn it! I hate it!
If you hate it so much, why don't you get out?
Why don't you?
It's crossed my mind.
Well, do it. Is there anything you can tell me about this investigation?
Anything more?
The Senate lawyer, Questad.
He belongs to Roth.
Sato, you're nothing to me now. You're not a brother. You're not a friend. I don't want to know you or what you do. I don't want to see you at the hotels. I don't want you near my house. When you see our mother, I want to know a day in advance so I won't be there. You understand?
Mikey.
I don't want anything to happen to him while my mother's alive.
Sal, come out and take a look, all right? What hope you got?
Huh?
Come on, quit while you're ahead. All you got is attempted robbery.
Armed robbery.
All right, armed then.
Yeah.
Nobody's been hurt. Release the hostages. Nobody's gonna worry over kidnapping charges. The most you're gonna get is 5 years. You get out in 1 year, huh?
Kiss me, yeah.
What?
Kiss me. When I'm being fucked, I like to get kissed,
hey,
a
come
lot.
Come on, come on, now, come on.
You're a city cop, right? Robbing a bank's a federal offense. They got me on kidnapping, armed robbery. They're gonna bury me, man. I don't wanna talk to somebody who's trying to calm me. Get somebody in charge here.
I am in charge.
I don't
here.
Wanna talk to some flunky pig trying to calm me, man.
You don't have to be calling.
What's
pig.
He doing?
And will you get back
what
over there?
What are you there? Moving in there for?
Will you What's get the doing? Fuck back there? Huh? Get back
What's
there,
What's he doing? Look at him, will
Go
you?
On. Get over there.
Go on back there, man.
Get over there, will you?
He wants to kill me so bad he can taste it.
Oh, God, I was gonna kill him.
Erica! Erica!
Will you?
Erica! 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 Throw off the funny old fucking bag!
No, 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 come on, come on!
Calm down, will you? Calm down!
You found him?
I found you. I thought you might have told me, you know, that you were going.
It's difficult to talk sometimes.
It is. Difficult.
To a good wind, dear Field.
You know, Lillian, that I made a special trip. I did. I came all the way down from Paris just to see you.
I
you
really know? Appreciate it.
You do. And you show your appreciation by leaving me, so I wake up alone. That are you sure?
Please, dear Phil, don't pout. This is a regatta. One doesn't pout at a regatta, dear.
I'm not pouting. We spend the day together, we spend the night together, and then I wake up and you're gone. Now, you could have had the decency to wake me up, Lillian.
Merci,
tell me you were going. Oh, there's the guy with the salon.
Ah, merci beaucoup. Into the gondola.
Lillian, you're not a very dependable person.
Why don't you come with us? No rabbits in the sky. Please come.
I'm the commander, Delfield. I will do everything. You would like to come with us? Everybody is ready. We are going.
One nation under God, indivisible, with liberty
and justice for all.
What the hell is wrong with you? What do you think you're doing in my car?
Look, tell me about it. You tell me about Aggie. Come on, Warren, tell me about it.
It got by me.
caballo. El caballo.
What? Caballo! Damn it! Caballo! Jesus! Just stay away from the car!
Aggie did not have to go to jail! Do you understand? He did not have to go to jail!
Well, he gets out on probation in 10 months! Listen, that's not all my fault! You know I don't like those penny ante bullshit cases. I was doing you a favor.
Favor? What kind of favor?
It's nickel and dime, Arthur. It's all nickel and dime.
Don't you care, Warren? Don't you even care?
If you care so much, why weren't you in the courtroom? You're goddamn right I care, but not about them.
They're people, Warren. You know? They're people. They're just...
If he's not in jail this week, he'll be in jail next week. Oh, God, the goddammit, you know probation's at fault. Appeal it!
Oh, I can't appeal it! He's dead! He's dead! Half hour after they put him in the lockup, he hanged himself.
What's happening?
I'm with someone.
Aren't we all? Want to dance?
There weren't a whole lot of Armenians in Bridgeport. I mean, not what you would call a huge Armenian community. I actually wasn't an Armenian until I was 7.
What? You weren't an Armenian until you were 7?
Until I was 7.
You mean you weren't born Armenian? You converted to Armenianism?
Yeah, sort of. I was an orphan. I was adopted.
Really?
I was what they call an abandoned child. I was found in an apple crate on the steps of a police station in West Bridgeport.
What'd your daddy do?
He was in the apple crate business.
No. That's a joke, right?
Yeah. He taught 5th grade.
Really?
Yeah.
Were you in his class?
No.
No? I don't think I've ever known an Armenian. I mean, besides you. I'm not sure about that, but how do you know if someone's Armenian or not?
Well, you can always tell an Armenian because his last name rhymes with the word Armenian.
Armenian!
See that?
Let her go, let her go. Another quaalude, you're gonna love me again.
We're looking at. You're all a bunch of fucking assholes. You know why? You don't have the guts to be what you want to be. You need people like me. You need people like me so you can point your fucking fingers and say, that's the bad guy. So, what I make you? Good? You're not good. You just know how to hide. How to lie. Me, I don't have that problem. Me, I always tell the truth. Even when I lie. So say good night to the bad guy. Come on. The last time you're gonna see a bad guy like this again, let me tell you. Come on. Make way for the bad guy. There's a bad guy coming through.
$20, that's it. Right six.
Come on, don't be all day, mister. Boats and Providence, 1776. Oh, you've had this a long time, haven't you? All right, 10, 20, 30, 40, that's it.
Coming next?
David?
Wait, where's the rest?
What rest, mister?
$70.
They've been devalued. That's all them old Continentals is worth now. Can you take it or leave it?
Hey, move along, you're holding up the queue.
Don't be pushing me.
I'm not pushing, I'm very busy now. Come on.
What happened to the 150 acres?
What are you complaining about?
I'm not complaining, I'm asking a question. What happened to the 150 acres I was promised?
Listen, you got two arms and two legs and two eyes, haven't you? Now move on, I'm very busy. Right.
I told you, keep your hands off me.
You're holding up the line,
I'm
mister.
I'm asking you a question.
You're holding up
I'm
the line.
I'm asking you a question. What happened to the 150 acres of land I was promised?
It was sold by Congress to speculators to pay for the war debt. All right? Now move it!
I'm the bloody war debt.
Are you?
Yeah, this chick here, that's a bloody war debt. We all are bloody war debt.
So why don't you go to Congress? Yeah, yeah. Don't tell me! You go to Congress, all of you, and you tell them!
No, I'll tell you, standing here.
I'm not interested in talking to you. Come on, next.
Where's this Congress you're talking
about? Congress is coming here.
Where?
You go and tell them.
Where they coming?
They're on their way.
When?
They're coming, damn you! I told you they're coming!
Damn you.
Go on, get out!
All these men here, we all fought for something, and we got it.
Yeah. Well, you think I didn't fight?
You take it from us, and we're gonna fight again.
I'm taking nothing from you. You open your mouth to Congress.
Do you remember when we met? That's the day I knew you were my pet.
Get in bed.
Jesus. Oh, my goodness. Holy fuck. What the fuck? Oh, shit. Holy fuck. Oh, my God. Holy fuck. Oh, I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Oh, fuck. Jesus. What'd you do? Where'd you put it?
Open this
fucking door!
She stole this pistol. I saw the button.
You goddamn son of a bitch! You goddamn piece of never fucking put your hands on
me! I got scared.
You tell me about scared, you don't know.
What are you doing with a Stardust pistol?
It's none of your goddamn business.
All right, okay.
Get off of me.
Listen to me. Listen to me. I saw the gun sticking out of the purse. I freaked, okay? It was a reflex. Look, feel my heart. Feel it. Go ahead. It's like a drum. Feel it?
I don't live up to the old...
No. You got it all wrong. And even if that were the case, we'd forgive you, wouldn't we, Ray? Oh, you're very, very tired. But you sell yourself so cheap. Don't defend yourself. You got to put yourself out a bit. They'll defend you as much as they can, David, but when it comes to crucial issues, you're out on your own. You haven't done half of it. Well, let's leave that for a bit. Right? Turn to the more rational side. How would you assess his physical condition and stature? In a few words, right? For guidance.
Well, I'll say about 6 feet. 13 stone. Well covered. Fairly good working order, I should think.
Said you were very approachable, David. Kick him in the stomach, get him on the ground, put your handkerchief in his mouth, kick him again, we see what follows.
Lunchtime, crowds were paralyzed by the suddenness of the crime. Not a hand was raised in protest. Organized crime is their name.
Every time some citizen buys a pound of hamburger, we get a nickel. Every time some guy gets a haircut, we get a dime. We'll dress like bankers. Join the Rotary Club. Together, we will own this town.
Why, you?
Excuse me.
Hey, when do we kill Dick Tracy?
As you know. If anything happens to Tracy, I'm the prime suspect. Leave Dick Tracy to me.
I say we kill Tracy now.
You say?
I say.
I say you say nothing. I say, you get behind me, we all profit. You challenge me, we all go down. There was one Napoleon, one Washington, one me.
I'm out.
It only works if we're all in.
Then it don't work. I got a good business. I'll take my chances alone.
Let him go, let him go. It's still a free country. Maybe you'll have a change of heart.
I always felt responsible for you. You know that. Your father, my brother, we were opposites. We would fight and argue. But I never doubted his love. He would do anything for me. But his temper. Too much. clouded his reason. I don't want you to make that mistake. Also, he too had a way with women. Vincent.
So I hear.
What are you doing with my daughter? What are you doing? It's too dangerous. Hear me? Okay.
And James, so.
When they come, they'll come at what you love.
I will go. Only I want to make a call. You know, this all should be so easy. Why is it always so damn hard? Hello, Midnight with Marlon? Oh, hello, Marlon. My name is Johnny, and I would like to know the name of that particular piece of piano music you were just playing a minute ago. So I could go out and buy the record, present it to my lady love, whose name happens to be Frankie, and is that not a coincidence? Frankie and Johnny. Debussy. Claude Debussy. Right. Claire de Lune. You got that?
Why are you doing this?
Everything I want is in this room. Hello, Marvin. You stupid fucking cunt. You, Williamson, I'm talking to you, shithead. You just cost me $6,000. $6,000 and one Cadillac. That's right. What are you gonna do about it? What are you gonna do about it, asshole? You fucking shit. Where did you learn your trade, you stupid fucking cunt, you idiot? Whoever told you that you could work with men?
Could I,
Oh, I'm gonna have your job, shithead. I'm going downtown. I'm gonna talk to Mitch and Murray. I'm going to Lemkin. I don't care whose nephew you are, who you know, whose dick you're sucking on, you're going out. I swear to you, hey, you're going...
Let's get this done.
Anyone in this office lives on his wits. I'm gonna be with you in a second. What you're hired for is to help us. Does that seem clear to you? To help us, not to fuck us up. To help men who are going out there to try to earn a living, you fairy, you company man. I'll tell you something else. I hope you rip the joint off. I can tell our friend here a little something might help him to catch you. You want to learn the first rule you'd know if you ever spent a day in your life. You never open your mouth till you know what the shot is. ¶¶
stuck with me, Charlie.
No, I'm not. I'm out of here.
Oh, yeah? Where you going? New Hampshire? You got no money? How you gonna do that? Karen's number tastes like Albany. Ah!
Fine. I'm leaving.
Charlie! Charlie! All I want from you is another day.
For what?
One last tour of the battlefield. I can get around a city like New York, but I sometimes need a point in the right direction. What do you say, Charlie? What's one day between friends?
All right. We'll say I stay for another day. Will you give me your weapon?
Oh, Charlie. I'm a lieutenant colonel, United States Army. I'm not giving my fucking gun to anyone. Now, what are you drinking?
Colonel, this is unacceptable.
Unacceptable? What do you give me that prep school crap for? Unacceptable. What have they done? Taking the argon out of the boy? Put in Harvard Business School?
Well, then give me your bullets.
Sasso.
No, no more Sasso. Now everybody call me Ron.
Ron.
Ron from Reynaldo.
Okay, Ron, let's get to the point. I hear you're doing good business with this place.
Very good.
So how come you need money?
Me?
Yeah, you gambling again, right? How much you owe?
I don't know, maybe 50, 60 so.
Okay, that means about 100. Who you owe the money to?
You know, Charles, some of the boys, 25 will quiet them for now, and you will come in for a quarter of my end.
Okay, I'm gonna give you 25,000 cash tomorrow. I'm gonna come in for half your end.
What are you trying to do to me?
What I'm trying to do, Sasso, I mean Ron, is save your ass.
My ass?
That's right, because it's either Fat Anthony or schools you owe the money to, right? Either way, you're gonna end up in the trunk of a car somewhere on the Belt Parkway before long, maybe weeks before they find you. Like Dee Dee, remember? They open her up. That's some kind of stink you're gonna make. Ooh, what's that smell? Sasso, man. That's Sasso. Used to be wrong.
Okay, what time tomorrow?
Die outside, where God can see me. You talk to me about hospital. What hospital? Me, who come home on the same boat with your uncle.
Oh, don't start.
You know the kind of man he
don't
was?
Don't start with me.
You think I'm less? Get my hat. Oh. Janardine. You know what I saw when I was laying there? You know what I saw? I saw heaven.
Honest?
Oh, yeah. I was no more than half a block away. And you know what it looked like? It looked just like the new La Paloma.
Thank you.
It's ready. Vincent. This is my friend Ralph.
You didn't tell me you were... Oh, my God.
Where's Lori?
She's at Lisa Beth's.
Look, this has nothing to do with me. I didn't know. I'm terribly sorry.
What are you sorry about? Sit down.
Don't you even get angry?
I'm angry.
Oh.
Yeah? I'm very angry, Ralph. You know, you can ball my wife if she wants you to. You can lounge around here on her sofa. In her ex-husband's dead tech post-modernistic bullshit house if you want to. But you do not get to watch my fucking television set.
For God's sake. Put the television set down.
I never cheated on you, bitch.
Well, maybe you should have.
Should have?
The way you're a part of this.
Oh, yeah, I made Ralph fuck you because it makes me feel good.
Our situation is absurd.
Look, maybe I should...
Shut up! Ralph, sit down!
Well, why is it that I have to figure things out and explain them to you? What do you do?
I say what I mean, and I do what I say.
How admirable.
You bet.
Except none of it's about us.
No.
I may be stoned on grass and Prozac, but you've been walking through our life dead. And now I have to demean myself with Ralph just to get closure with you.
Where have you been?
Had me a busy night.
I'm sure you did.
You read this morning's operations printout?
What about it?
I was with Vinny Zapati last night. He's dead because of Tino Zapati's probation report. Now there's four deaths. They're connected. That's all I know. That much I learned.
And that's all I wanna know.
Just trying to circle the wagons here.
Circle the wagons? Who do you think you are? Some gumshoe in a dime novel, loose cannoning around the city, consorting with known mobsters? Kevin, for God's sakes, you're my right hand. You're the mayor's right hand. What are you fucking around for? You see this desk? This desk belonged to Fiorello LaGuardia, the little flower. He was about 5 foot tall, used to read the funny papers to his constituents' children over the radio, and was about the best goddamn mayor the city ever had. You know what LaGuardia said? Why is it every time you can do some good, the nice people come in and mess you up? Kevin, be nice, don't mess me up.
I'm gonna show you something, Donnie.
What?
And I want you to look at it very carefully. And then I want you to think very carefully about what you say to me. That's a federal bolt, Donnie.
I really don't think that's the same bolt.
That's the same bolt. It's got the name on it. Name, the left hand. It's like my name. That's that Abscam bolt.
You think I knew that was a federal bolt? You think I'm a fucking rat?
How many times I have you into my own house?
twice a week at least.
Yeah, there it is, at least. I cook for you.
Yeah?
If ever I had any money, I'd give you. I never had any money, but if ever I had $100 in my pocket, I'd give you 50, right?
Yeah, you did.
If you're a rat, if you're a rat, then I'm the biggest fucking mutt in the history of the mafia.
Even if this thing is a federal boat left. They scam all these other people, they didn't scam us. You know what I'm saying? We went, we had a great party, we walked away from it.
How do you know that we walked away from it?
Well, we're sitting here, right? So they tried to outsmart us, but we outsmarted them. We beat the agents. You gotta believe me.
Okay. Let's go do this work.
Don't get too cocky, my boy, no matter how good you are. Don't ever let them see you coming. That's the gaffe, my friend. You gotta keep yourself small, innocuous. Maybe the little guy. You know, the nerd, the leper, shit-kicking surfer. Look at me. Underestimated from day one. You'd never think I was a master of the universe now, would you? That's your only weakness, as far as I can see.
What's that?
It's the look. That Florida stud thing. What is that?
Excuse me, ma'am. Did I leave my boots under your bed?
Never worked a jury didn't have a woman.
Yeah, but you know what you're missing? You're missing what I have. There's this beautiful girl just fucked me 40 ways from Sunday. We're done. She's walking to the bathroom. She's trying to walk. She turns. She looks. It's me. Not the Trojan army, just fucked her. Little old me. She gets this look on her face, like, how the hell did that happen? I'm the hand of Mona Lisa's skirt. I'm a surprise, Kevin. They don't see me coming. That's what you're missing. Where's the chicken?
What?
I want to talk to you.
Good, I want to talk to you. This is
I
my house.
I did not
in front of my wife,
you,
my kids.
I did not give you up to anyone.
What business do we have?
To straighten something out with you. Right here, right now.
Can you even mention my name? You haven't talked to anybody about
what
me?
Am I
why
am
Brown and Williamson? No, I spoke
how
to
the
you.
How the hell do I know about Brown
and Williamson?
It
happened just after I talked to you.
I don't know. What
I
do
not
that?
Like coincidence.
Well, I don't like paranoid accusations. I'm a journalist. Think. Use your head. How do I operate as a journalist? By screwing the people who could provide me with information before they provided me with it.
You came all the way down here to tell me that?
No, I did not. Big Tobacco is a big story, and you got something important to say, I can tell. But yes, I did. I came all the way down here to tell you. Story, no story. Fuck your story. I don't burn people.
I was a great football player, but nobody gave me a time or a day or a season to let my shoulder heal, and then they just traded me out of there.
That's right. You go ahead. Blame everybody but yourself, Willie.
Whatever.
You see, because that's what a leader's about. Sacrifice. The times he's got to sacrifice because he's got to lead by example, not by fear and not by self-pity.
Who you think you're talking to? Half of my football career is over. Hey, you want me to go back to the bench to sacrifice for the greater glory of Cap Rooney? Well, fuck you, coach. I ain't buying your brand. Just because you're some scared old man. You feel like if I play my way, I just might win. And then what the fuck was your life about anyway?
You're not some flash in the pan, corner or receiver, or even Julian Washington. You're a goddamn quarterback! You know what that means? It's the top spot, kid. It's the guy takes the fall. It's the guy everybody's looking at first, the leader of a team. Who will support you when they understand you. Who will break their ribs and their noses and their necks for you because they believe. Because you make them believe. That's a quarterback.